Thanks very much. Appreciate you all being here. I hope a couple of you have surfed in New Jersey. But most people don't realize that there's a lot of surprises about surfing in New Jersey. This depiction of the Police Gazette from 1888 is entitled Riding the Waves in Asbury Park. Historians have tried to find out if this is true or not true. If this is true, it's the first example of surfing in the continental United States. Bradley, the founder of Asbury Park, was known as a P.T. Barnum-type character, and maybe or maybe not, it's true. We don't know. We do know that Duke Kahanamoku surfed in Atlantic City at the Million Dollar Pier in 1912. The Duke was the Michael Phelps of his era. On his way to the Olympics in Europe, he spent a lot of time training in Atlantic City, and he also spent a great deal of time in this area. Duke surfed in 1912, he stimulated interest, he came back again in the 20s and in the 30s, and people enjoyed looking at him, watching him. Everyone likes to watch surfers, and some men learned how to surf on old wooden boards in the 1930s and 20s. The New Jersey Surfing Museum down in Tuckerton has some examples of some of the boards that they used. If you've traveled around the world, you realize, and certainly this statue is in Waikiki, Duke is considered the father of modern surfing. He introduced surfing to Australia, to Europe. In his travels, he is really probably the most renowned surfer in surfing history. And as I said, surfed in New Jersey, 1912. If you've been to an airport, if you've been driven down Route 95 to Florida, if you've been to California, if you've been to Australia, you're familiar with that logo. Ron John's Surf Shop, which originally was right between the eastbound and westbound lanes on the causeway and going into Long Beach Island. Ron DeMano wanted to buy a surfboard. And his dad, being a good New Jersey entrepreneur, said, well, don't just buy one, buy three, sell two, and you'll have one for free. So he got a pretty good idea. John Spatafora, another Long Beach Island area resident, they started Ron John. Ron John has turned into an iconic label known throughout the world. The original shop, now it's not, they call it the original, it's still on LBI, but it's not quite the same. 1967, the Eastern Surfing Association morphed from the New Jersey Surfing Association. Surfing in New Jersey in the 50s and 60s became a really popular sport. Cecil Lear founded the New Jersey Surfing Association in the 60s in Belmar. Belmar and Ocean City were amongst the very first communities around the country with designated surfing beaches and who saw surfers as not just a bunch of lowlifes. Cecil is still alive. The ESA is having its contest right now. Surfers, thousands of surfers from Maine to Florida in the largest amateur surfing association in the world, which started in Belmar. They're down in the Outer Banks right now. And of course, you can't talk about New Jersey and you can't talk about surfing without mentioning Springsteen. Most people don't realize that back in the day, Bruce actually, I'll hesitate to say lived, I'll say crashed, in a couple of surf shops. Bruce spent a lot of time crashing. In Neptune, there was a shop where they manufactured Challenger East surfboards. Carl Tinker West was a shaper, shaped surfboards there. Bruce lived there, and after a while, Bruce moved over to Long Branch, where he lived with Vince Tronick in the famous Islander surf shop, which was right on the borderline of Monmouth Beach and Long Branch. Bruce actually surfs quite a lot. He still shows up periodically when he's not on tour, when he's trying to be invisible, because in the lineup, he doesn't look like Bruce Springsteen. He just looks like another guy surfing. What people don't realize as I travel all over the world is that there is surfing in New Jersey. Most people look at me and go, New Jersey surfer? The two things just pretty much don't make sense. So I hope as you think about surfing, you'll think about the contributions our state has made to surfing and the surf culture, and maybe you'll get a chance to try surfing some point here in New Jersey. Thank you very much.